Hello everyone and welcome back to the Perfect French with Dylan. Today we're gonna learn 20 idioms with colors. We are going to see idioms with blanc, bleu, noir, rose, vert et rouge. There's no PDF on the first day, but all the idioms are going to be in the description box. You can just copy them and keep them. For this week's video on Monday, we saw how to ask a question using quand, comment, pourquoi, où, combien. The link for this video and all the videos we are going to talk about today are all going to be in the description box. Quick announcement, I had a lot of people asking me if they can buy my ebook on another place than Amazon because they don't have a Kindle or for many reasons. And it was not possible before, but it will be possible on my website on June 22nd. So on June 22nd, you will be able to buy the Little French Dictionary of Word Families on my website. And then also on June 22nd, my new book is coming up, The 1000 Most Common French Words with Sentences. All that on June 22nd. All right, let's start the lesson. So today I'm going to give you the idioms in French, then I'm going to translate it in English with the literal translation, and then I'm going to give you the meaning, and then we'll see in a sentence. So the first one we start is with the color blanc, blanche. I will put the video about adjectives, about everything down in the description box if you don't know why it changed. So the first one, passer une nuit blanche. Passer une nuit blanche. The literal translation is to spend a white night. And it actually means to have a sleepless night. So you can say, j'ai passé une nuit blanche. J'ai passé une nuit blanche. Blanche. So you stay awake all night. Numéro 2, you should know this one. Donner carte blanche. Donner carte blanche. To give a white card. So it means to give free rein to someone. But you also have this one in English. You say, I give carte blanche. So if you're an English speaker, you might know it already. So let's see in a sentence. Le patron lui a donné carte blanche. Le patron lui a donné carte blanche. The boss gave him free rein. The boss gave him carte blanche. Numéro 3, être blanc comme un linge. Être blanc comme un linge. The translation would be to be as white as a sheet. To be as white as a sheet. It actually means to be as white as a ghost or to be pale. You could say that for me as well, but it's more when someone is looking sick, more than just, you know, the natural color of the skin. So you can say, il est blanc comme un linge. Est-ce qu'il est malade? Il est blanc comme un linge. Est-ce qu'il est malade? He's as white as a ghost. Is he sick? Numéro 4, almost the same one. Être blanc comme neige. Être blanc comme neige. To be as white as snow. And it has a totally different meaning. It just means to be innocent. So in a sentence. La police n'a pas arrêté le voisin. Il est blanc comme neige. La police n'a pas arrêté le voisin. Il est blanc comme neige. The police didn't arrest the neighbor, is innocent. Numéro 6, the last one for blanc, for white. Se faire des cheveux blancs. Se faire des cheveux blancs. To get white hair. And it actually means to worry too much, to have too much stress. Because when you have too much stress, people say that you get white hair. Elle se fait des cheveux blancs pour un rien. Elle se fait des cheveux blancs pour un rien. She worries too much for nothing. Now we start with bleu, the color bleu. Bleu. This one we might know it. Être un cordon bleu. Être un cordon bleu. That means to be a very good cook. Mon père était un vrai cordon bleu. Mon père était un vrai cordon bleu. My dad was a very good cook. Numéro 8, être fleur bleue. Être fleur bleu. The translation would be to be a blue flower, but it actually means to be sentimental. So if you say, ma fille est très fleur bleue, ma fille est très fleur bleue. Remember that fille, we don't say fille, fille. It's fille, it's a long E. So you place the L by like E-E-E, fille. Ma fille est très fleur bleue. My daughter is very sentimental. Numéro 9, avoir une peur bleue. Avoir une peur bleue. To have a blue fear simply means to be afraid of something. For example, j'ai une peur bleue des araignées. J'ai une peur bleue des araignées. I'm afraid of spiders. This is totally true for me. So leave me a comment and tell me what are you afraid of with that sentence. J'ai une peur bleue de something. Now we start with noir. Noir, black. Avoir des idées noires. Avoir des idées, idées noires. To have black ideas. Simply means to have dark thoughts, to be depressed. Il a beaucoup d'idées noires ces derniers jours. Il a beaucoup d'idées noires ces derniers jours. He has a lot of dark thoughts these last few days. Numéro 11, broyer du noir. Broyer du noir. To crush black, that's kind of what I came with, but I don't think it's a really weird way to say it even. To crush black, that would be what we translate it to. That means to have the blues, to not be in a good mood. So you can just say, elle broie du noir. Elle broie du noir. She has the blues, she is not in a good mood. Numéro 12, travailler au noir. Travailler au noir. To work in black. It just means that you work under the table. To work under the table. So, il n'a pas de contrat de travail, il travaille au noir. Il n'a pas de contrat de travail, il travaille au noir. He doesn't have a work contract, he works under the table. Now we get to pink, rose. Numéro 13, voir la vie en rose. Voir la vie en rose. It's a very common one, so maybe you really know it. To see life in pink. To see life in pink. What could it mean? It means to be very optimistic. To be a very optimistic person. Elle est toujours de bonne humeur in a good mood. Elle est toujours de bonne humeur. Elle voit la vie en rose. Elle est toujours de bonne humeur. Elle voit la vie en rose. She's always in a good mood. She is very optimistic. Now we go with green. Vert. 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 Verte. Numéro 14. Donner le feu vert. Donner le feu vert. To give the green light. It means to give the go-ahead. To give the go-ahead. Donner le feu vert. Son patron lui a donné le feu vert pour son projet. Son patron lui a donné le feu vert pour son projet. His boss gave him the go-ahead with his project. Numéro 15, another green one, se mettre au vert. Se mettre au vert. I came with the translation to put yourself in green. It's quite hard to translate, to be honest. It actually means to move to the countryside. Se mettre au vert. Il va se mettre au vert après sa retraite. Il va se mettre au vert après sa retraite. He will move to the countryside after his retirement. Numéro 16. Être vert de rage. Être vert de rage. To be green in rage. Just mean to be furious. So in a sentence, tu aurais dû le voir, il était vert de rage. tu aurais dû le voir. You should have seen him. If you don't know about should, would, could, I will also put a few videos about that in the description box. Tu aurais dû le voir, il était vert de rage. Numéro 17, very close one as well. Être vert de jalousie. Être vert de jalousie. And this one, you have one actually in English. To be green with envy. So if you see the exact same sentence. Tu aurais dû le voir, il était vert de jalousie. Tu aurais dû le voir, il était vert de jalousie. The last one for green, avoir la main verte. Avoir la main verte. To have a green hand. I'm sure you know this one, Karina. Means to have a green thumb, to be a good gardener. Elle a la main verte, son jardin est magnifique. Elle a la main verte, son jardin est magnifique. Numéro 19, now with rouge, rouge, être dans le rouge. Être dans le rouge. And you have the exact same one as well. To be in the red. J'ai appris qu'il était dans le rouge. J'ai appris qu'il était dans le rouge. I heard that he was in the red. Numéro 20, être rouge de honte. Être rouge de honte. You know, when you're really ashamed, it kind of turn red. So, to be red in shame means just to be ashamed. Il était rouge de honte. Il était rouge de honte. He was ashamed. That's it for today. Let me know which one was your favorite in the comment section. Also, if you have a question about French, leave me a comment. I will do my best to help you. You can also contact me on my Instagram, my Facebook page, and this YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel as well. And I will see you soon for another lesson.